The last advanced editing technique that we need to cover before we jump into this edit is track targeting. And this is super important. You really need to know this. If you don't, it's gonna cause you all sorts of headaches. So y'all know we're leveling up for this edit, and that means we're gonna be filling up a lot of different tracks on this timeline. And sometimes we're gonna need to tell Premiere what track we're working on or what track we're targeting when we're doing stuff, or it's not gonna work. So for example, I've got a timeline here. It's got a lot of stuff on it. And let's say that I want to copy this clip. So I'll select this clip and press Command C, and I wanna paste it over on this part of my timeline. So watch what happens when I press Command V. That clip gets pasted on top of another clip on track one, and now it is messing up my edit. I don't want this. I want this clip to be pasted where there is a nice little open space on track three. And so in order for that to happen, I need to tell Premiere that that's what I want. I need to tell Premiere that I am targeting track three for this action. So how do I do that? Well, I'm gonna go to the front of my timeline because that's where we do all the things when we wanna control our tracks, right? We can lock them here, we can hide them here, we can mute them here. And this column right here is where we target our track. So if we hover over this column, you'll see that it says toggle track targeting either on or off for this track. So if I wanna tell Premiere, yo, track three is where I want this clip pasted, then I need to click here to toggle track targeting on for this track. So if it's blue, that means the track is targeted. And I also need to turn track targeting off for all the other tracks that I don't want this clip pasted on. And now I can go over here and press Command V, and Premiere is going to paste my clip exactly where I want. I can also target audio tracks. So let's say I copy this clip here that has audio linked to it, and I target video track two and audio tracks three and four. Then if I paste the clip over here, it's only going on the tracks that I targeted. Now, track targeting not only affects the copy and paste command, it also affects navigation commands, like when we press the up down arrows to jump from clip to clip. So if I have all the tracks targeted, then when I press the down arrow, we're gonna stop at every single clip, no matter what track it's on. But if I just target track one, then we are only hopping between the clips on that track when I press the down arrow. Track targeting also affects our shortcut for selecting clips, which is the D key. So remember, if you press the D key, you're gonna select any clips that are at the playhead on your timeline, but that's only going to happen on the tracks that you have targeted. So if I've got all the tracks targeted and I press the D key here, then all these clips are going to be selected, but if only track two is targeted and I press the D key, then just the clip on that track is selected. And lastly, track targeting also affects our super efficient shortcut for cutting or splitting clips, which is Shift G. So remember, whenever we press Shift G, it's going to cut whatever clips are at the playhead, but only on the tracks that you target. And so a lot of times, like if I'm just doing audio correction, I'm just working on these two audio tracks, then I will just target them so that I can quickly go through, press that Shift G, and just make cuts to those tracks. So to recap, track targeting affects the copy paste command, the up down arrow keys and other navigation shortcuts, the Shift G shortcut that makes a cut at the playhead, and the D key shortcut that selects clips at the playhead. So it affects a lot. And so when I'm editing, I am constantly targeting different tracks, and y'all know I don't wanna have to move my mouse all the way across the screen and do all this clicking to do that. And so what I've done is I've gone up into my Premiere Pro menu, I've gone to keyboard shortcuts, and I've typed in toggle target. And then I've set all my function number keys to toggle targeting for my audio tracks 1 through 8. And then I've set all my regular number keys 1 through 8 to toggle targeting for my video tracks. And that way when I'm on my timeline, I can just press 1, 2, 3, 4 and I've got those first four video tracks targeted much more quickly. So that is track targeting, this column here of little V's and A's, but you may notice that there is another column here on the left side of V's and A's, and you may be thinking, what is that about? Well, if I hover my mouse over this left column, you will see that it says source patching for inserts and overwrites. And y'all, that was a lot of words, and so let's break down what this means. Source is talking about your source footage over here. And patch is just something that people in the TV business say when they are connecting a video or audio feed. And so source patching means that when you click a piece of source footage over here in your project panel, it's going to get added to the tracks that you select here in this source patching column. And so if I press the comma key right now to insert this clip, it's going to get added on video track one and audio track one. Or if I set the source patching to video track 2 and audio track 2, then the clip gets inserted on those tracks when I press the comma key. And so that's how source patching works for inserting clips on our timeline, but we can also use it to overwrite clips on our timeline, and we do that by pressing the period key. Or you can also overwrite clips by just dragging a clip on top of another one on your timeline. Now you might be like, why would I write over footage on my timeline? Well, maybe you've got some A-roll or some speaking footage on video track 1, and you want to layer some B-roll on track 2, so you'll set the source patching there. And then you can just select the clips you want to add in the project panel and press the period key to sprinkle them in. Now, when it comes to source patching, if the piece of source footage that you've got selected in your project panel has both video and audio, then you're going to see both a V1 and an A1 in this source patching column that you can click and move to the tracks that you want this source footage patched to when you press the comma key. Now, if the piece of source footage you've got selected only has video, then you're only going to see a V1 in the source patching column, and you're not going to see anything in the audio tracks. Now, if the source asset you've got selected in the project panel has multiple video and audio tracks, like the sequence here, then that's also going to be reflected in the source patching column. And we can decide exactly which tracks we want all of these different layers to go on when we press the comma key to insert. Finally, let's say you have a piece of source footage that has video and audio, but let's say the audio sucks and you don't want to add it, then you can also click to deselect a track in this source patching column. And now when I press the period key, only my video is getting added and not the audio. Now you don't have to use source patching when you're adding clips to your timeline if this is all way too much for you, but it is really nice to know about if you ever accidentally turn off the video track for source patching and then you're trying to add a clip to your timeline and you're like, why is only the audio being added? Now you know, all you need to do is go over here, turn that video back on for source patching, you'll be able to add that clip, no problem, and you will avoid a lot of emotional distress. So I hope that made sense. Track targeting is a column that's closer to the timeline. It affects clips already on your timeline. Source patching is closer to your source footage and it affects those source clips that you haven't yet added to your timeline. You've been watching an excerpt from the Big Video Course, which is where I teach clueless beginners how to make videos like experts. You can learn more and you can watch a free preview of the course by visiting marybetsy.com/BVC or by clicking the link below.